Welcome back, everyone. The season of giving can also be a season of excess. It's easy to overspend and wind up with credit card debt. Consumer reporter Jennifer Profit in the studio with us tonight with how we can still give generously without getting into trouble.
Not easy to do, Bill. So this is expected to be our most expensive season yet. Consumers spending nearly $970 each, according to the National Retail Federation. We checked in with a local financial professional for ideas on how to give big but protect our budgets. We give gifts to others. We give to charity this time of year, but how do you give to yourself?
We're spending more. People seem to splurge more.
This is financial professional Mindy McIntosh of McIntosh & Associates in Freeland. See, about a quarter of Americans buy gifts for themselves this time of year, according to market research firm Mintel. Instead of splurging on something you might not need, Mindy says there's a better way to treat yourself.
Sometimes it's just giving to yourself without any money. Just give yourself time, go hit the gym, read a book.
Or save some money in case of an emergency. Think 3 to 6 months worth of expenses on hand. If you can, bump up your 401k. When it comes to giving gifts to others, Mindy says create a budget and stick to it.
Not only the normal utilities or household bills, but how do we budget for this holiday season with giving and spending of gift cards and gifts and presents and food and, you know, entertaining others.
If you're tempted to buy just a few more gifts before Christmas Day, go back to that budget. Mindy says stick to it like glue. Last, don't feel like you need to spend a fortune either. Homemade gifts show that you've spent time instead of money.
I have these homemade type of items that don't cost a lot. It's more come from the heart. Crafty type of items are great things to do this type of year too.
Since the season is so pricey, Mindy says it's the perfect time to educate your kids about spending and saving.
Where would you begin with something like that?
She suggests three piggy banks: spend, save, and donate. So when they get some cash, maybe as a Christmas gift, they have to decide, where am I going to put this in the piggy bank?
That's a cool idea. Mm-hmm. Our investigative unit has good authority that Santa is having some issues this year.
He's very busy, Bill, so he needs a little bit of extra help this time of year. And